Assalamualaikum and hello everyone. I welcome you to Pondering Thoughts with Nida Javed. The internet and social media kind of opens up that whole horizon of possibilities of someone's mind and narrowness of it. Having said that, if we're talking about hijab, hijab is what I'm wearing, all right? And I love my hijab and the reasons I wear it for. However, yes, there are some popular influencers who used to wear hijab and who took it off. I'm noticing that on social media, there are concerns, parents are talking, these influencers are being judged for making this decision. What are my pondering thoughts on this particular subject? I think it's very easy to see someone is changing and have an opinion about it. Of course, when you put yourself on a social media platform and you open the comments and your life is kind of public to everyone to comment and judge, you kind of have to grow a thick skin and accept what comes with it. The trolls and the fans covering off the head, especially for Muslim women. We have two groups, Muslim women who do wear hijab and Muslim women who don't. Fortunately for me, I have had experience in both areas. And unfortunately, I have been judged by both set of people. More harshly by those who wore it than those who did not. First of all, the minute you are judging someone, that alone is a character flaw. I go by this belief that God, Allah, did not give us a responsibility to judge anyone. For judgment, there is a judgment day. Regardless of the faith you follow, you know there is a hell, you know there is a heaven, and God has taken upon himself to judge us at the end of time, and he will decide where we go, depending on our deeds. So to actually judge someone based on I don't know how religious they are or what their connection with God is or how they are spoiling those who are following them. Leave that judgment. Do not judge someone for not wearing it. Likewise, someone who is not wearing it, do not judge others who are wearing hijab. One thing I'm noticing is that ladies who wear hijab do not comfortably mingle with those that don't. And those that don't wear hijab do not comfortably mingle with those that do. Why? Because there is a fear of judgment. The only way there will be a positive growth among women in Muslim community is number one, when you stop the judgment. Don't go, oh, she may have, you know, she may not have iman, or she may be evil, or she's doing this, or she's doing that. The fact you made all these guesses because you saw a woman not covering her head, that alone says, honey, the character flaw is not in her, it's in you. Likewise, if you are not wearing hijab and you see someone covering her head, then do not go judging, oh my goodness, I feel like she may be very judgmental, she's not gonna like me, she will judge me, or she may be very religious, or she is not educated, or she doesn't know any better, or she is oppressed. Quit judging. So leave the judgment to God and the individual. Worry about yourself. And second message that I have is for those who are very worried that these influencers have taken their hijab off and their little girls have been following them, buying their product, and all of a sudden this influencer has changed and made a decision that changes her from her perspective. Listen, ladies, your children's first influence comes from your home. Your daughters are seeing you judging someone else based on how they are living their life. So guess what your daughter is expecting? You to judge her life too, if she doesn't already feel that way.
You don't have to scold and tell your daughter that you have to wear it. This is what a Muslim woman does. This is how you need to cover it. This is how you need to see it. This is how things gotta be. No, you know how you influence it? just like how you expect her to be influenced by someone else. You practice what you want your daughters to learn. You want her to willfully wear hijab? Then become the person that enjoys wearing it. Do not judge someone else in her presence. Make her fall in love with this that she willfully chooses, and she does not need to take it off just because a stranger on social media took it off. You expect her to follow an influencer just by looking at them. Then why wouldn't you imagine, or why wouldn't you expect your daughter to follow you just by looking at you? She's more likely to do things that you show positivity in than an influencer. The debate between hijab and non-hijab has gone too far. Stop making hijab so political. Stop making it a subject of conversation or debate. It does not deserve that negativity to surround it. It deserves respect. If you don't wear it, respect it. If you do wear it, wear with the dignity it deserves. At the end of the day, we will be judged by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on our character first. Who were we to others? And my gosh, I will not be lying if I say I don't see judgment happening in every single corner. Every single person is judging another. Using your best judgments when it comes to your relationships and interactions is different than judging someone. If you see someone not wearing a hijab, two sisters should not go and talk about her behind their back. And you know what I see happening? You notice an influencer is beginning to, you know, a bunch of them have taken their hijabs off, and here you are on a wide social media among hundreds of women. This woman, this influencer, who is a Muslim, is being discussed publicly and having her character tarnished because, astaghfirullah, what has she done? Oh my goodness, hundreds of women coming together to tarnish a single woman's soul? And she is not even aware? Because when you talk behind someone's back, your good deeds go in their account for the day of judgment. So kudos to you for making her reach Jannah, even if her choice could have interfered with that. So good job. I guess technically you looked out for somebody. But why publicly discuss this? I see that you are concerned that your daughter is being influenced by this specific person. But like I said, your daughter also has peers. Your daughter also has female relatives. Your daughter also has you. Your daughter is in the same community as you are. And if you are finding members in the community that you are judging, guess what you're teaching your daughter? That people within your community are not good enough. And I'll tell you the two perspectives how I was judged on this choice, right? So the time I was not wearing hijab, there were specific people who judged me. And what were their comments? Exactly that. You're not religious. They somehow, hijab makes them feel entitled, as if they are better in religion than you are. They don't take time, those that are judging, they don't take time to learn about you. They do not ask questions about why you have chosen not to wear it, because at the end it could make sense. So they don't want to go through that track. When I was being judged for this, it was by people who automatically had an arrogant attitude because they wore hijab and somehow they are right in their practice and being a Muslim, and somehow I was wrong. That disturbed me the most. For them to assume I was not religious was wrong. How I looked and how I was dressing and how I was addressing the environment around me, I had my own reasons to make those choices at the time. I would have appreciated if this person who felt entitled to judge me had taken the time to ask the right questions, asked me my reasons, asked me my beliefs, or taken a time to get to know me a little better. Maybe that would have helped in judging me little more gentler than the harsh judgments they passed and the comments I heard. Moving forward, here I am. 3 years ago, I went through my own journey spiritually. I fell in love with hijab. I chose to wear it because I wanted to, because it became important to me. And, you know, it was a completely spiritual journey for me. This is a pilgrimage that many Muslims take once in their life, and some more than that if their finances allow. I was blessed with this trip and got to know a lot of people. And one of the lectures I was attending said a story. And I want to share that story with you. Jahala is a time before Islam came in existence. So during the time, women were of, there were women who were prostitutes and they looked a certain way. And this is in Arabia. Then there were women who were family women, respected women, and they were, you know, very well put together, and that was a separate category. So the looks of the women differentiated that which women were which. Okay? So at that time, in this specific lecture, I got to learn the women, one of the ways they differentiated between the two was that the women who respected themselves and were taken as respected women covered their head. And just hearing this portion of this lecture or story hit me so hard. And it hit me that we are preaching day and night, cover yourself, be modest, put hijab on. And women in Jahala and women pre-Islam time knew how to respect themselves. No one was telling them to do this. They just knew what makes them different than others. Allah knows best. That time is gone. I don't know the 100% realities of that time, but I got to know this part. Allah knows best what's true and not. But just the fact that pre-Islamic time, before God's order even came to cover yourself, and order more specifically was take your veil from the back and bring it to the front. It hit me that no one needed to tell the women who realized they need to be respected how to show that they're respected. They, by choice, covered their head. It hit me that women before pre-Islam knew how to respect themselves, and here I am trying to fit in a society just so I don't be judged, where I'm expected to not wear hijab, where I have to feel like I'm beautiful, where I have to work out really hard to look good in the clothes that I wear. They have to be a certain shape. My hair has to look a certain way, and I have to look the certain way because I wanted respect. And that's exactly what I did. I chose hijab because I started to respect myself. I wanted to take away the power from anyone in my surroundings from telling me what I need to look like. Because I decide who I am. I do not have to fit in a certain definition or category. Now, the judgment I faced after I came to wear it. Pleasant story, I tell you. Now this is how this part of the story goes. The same people who judged me for not wearing it came around and judged me for wearing it. And guess what some of the statements were? She just came from Hajj. She's showing off. It's a temporary phase. She's just showing how religious she has become. She's such a hypocrite. She's one person, now she's showing she's religious for wearing this. That the same people who judged me for not wearing it and did not care to ask me about my choice then were the same people who were judging me now and not wondering why I changed. When I put myself in the same places of influencers who are harshly being judged right now on open platforms from women, Muslim women, especially from around the world, it disheartens me because you are not asking the right questions. When you notice someone is changing, ask them why. If you are concerned, ask them what is making you change. And if they are posting their reasons, listen. The minute you notice your daughters don't want to do anything with you, at that moment you take a step back and do a character check. Become self-aware. Where did I lack that my daughter stopped paying attention to me? Where did I lack that my daughter does not want to get involved with me? Where did I lack that she started looking and finding support in other people, whether social media or her real life? Where did I lack that my daughter is not coming to me with her questions? Because if you were triggering her curiosity for hijab by wearing it, she would have asked you why you love it so much. Islam is practiced through love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do not become a Muslim for the society you can preach to. You become a Muslim and the society looks up to you for lessons. But if you go to the people and you say you are doing so wrong and you judge and you point out their mistakes and you nag, people will turn away from you. There are a lot of preachers out there, but it's time we start seeing practitioners. Keep loving, keep living. Have a nice day and rest of your life.